Well, the main small granite grows rye, and the main reason I grow it is for erosion control. You can see the kind of ground I got. I got a lot of rolling hills. I got a lot of C and D slopes, and so it's a way I've found that you can get some cover on the hills to hold the soil in place in the spring when you get them heavy spring rains. That's the main reason I started growing it. But after I started growing rye, well, then I found out that it makes good cow forage, and got to the point where I started seeding it 100% of my acres down. So then I decided that I could probably grow it myself since I was needing more seed. So that's kind of how we got into growing it for harvest. So one thing just kind of led to another, and it just, the longer you do it, the more uses you can find for it, and the more versatile it is. So it works out for about anything.
The grain that I produce here for small grains, I did oats and rye this year. All of that is used either on our farm or on neighboring farms. We have several farmers in our area that are getting into cover crops a lot bigger than they used to. And so they have demand, and they'd much rather buy it from their local neighbor than from a seed company. It's a matter of convenience, and it's a matter of just good neighborliness.
I guess the reason we decided to use the small grains, the way they fit for us is it gives us a lot more time to do a cover crop. We can plant the cover crop in July, get a lot of biomass, and then we graze it with cattle. Our cattle, it'll feed them rather economically the whole winter, or we try to as much as we can. They don't get it all. They trample about half, so that goes back into the soil to feed the microbes. Plus, they do a good job spreading the manure and whatnot. But I realized as I kept working with cover crops, there is just not enough time to get a lot of biomass, and we cannot get the diversity with just doing a cover crop between corn and soybeans. And so that's why we went to the wheat.